A big hello to Yearn to Learn viewers. This is Priya Handa, and today I'm going to talk about the Chrome extension Web Paint. Web Paint provides you easy to use drawing tools that let you draw shapes, lines, and add text to live web pages. And yes, you can also take screenshots. So let's know about it. Let's download it first. Go to the Chrome Web Store and search for Web Paint. Add to Chrome. Add extension. So once it is added, you can go to this icon here and pin it to your browser. So this yellow icon is of Web Paint. Now let us see how it allows us to draw and use its tools and features on a live web page. Now as a teacher, as an educator, you may use a lot of online resources these days. For example, this is a page where the rock cycle is there. I've just opened a random National Geographic page. So here you can see they have explained about rock cycle. Now how the Web Paint tool extension helps a teacher, an educator. So when we click here on the Web Paint icon, a window appears here which have a lot of tools. Now you can use these tools to annotate on this live web page. Now the first tool is a pencil tool, which draws a custom line with the selected line width and color. Now when I'm saying that, you can see here the color option is coming. Transparency you can select and the size. Now let's see this pencil first one. This is the color sky blue and the thickness of the pencil. Now I'm increasing the thickness and let's change the color. So this color palette is here. Let's come to violet. Okay, let's choose purple. So you see the color has changed here and the size also I've changed. Now you say that, okay, we are going to talk about the rock cycle today. So you have highlighted it. You can use it as you want it. I'll just give you some examples as per my own understanding. So you can choose that. Now when you move forth, you see there is another color picker tool here. Now what does this tool do? It selects a color for the text and line for you. For example, you don't know which color to use or choose, you're confused, but yes, you want to use this particular color, the one of the jacket. So what you can do, you can use this color picker and then click here. Now it has picked this color. If I click here, it will pick this color. So it can help you choose the colors from there. So this is the color picker, which will change the color of the pencil and will, this is white, so it is using white. Let me change it. So it will choose that color which you will use with the pencil. Coming to the next one, this is the text which is used for inserting text. Now I'm talking about sedimentary rocks. So I'm explaining what are sedimentary rocks to students. Then I am highlighting this example also that sandstone is one example. So sandstone, and then I feel that yes, I want to include some other example like shale. So I can just use text here. Shale or limestone are also the types of sedimentary rocks which may not be mentioned here. So I've just mentioned it. So I can use this text to annotate, to give extra notes to students. Then is the line tool. You can draw straight lines, sometimes say underline this line that organic sedimentary rocks like coal. So you can see this straight line is coming. Now instead of annotating with a hazy line, you can mark a straight line with this tool. Then is arrow. You can create an arrow. Okay, now further down we'll read about the igneous rocks, so you can mark this arrow. Or if you are writing about some equation, you can use the arrow or any other thing. Then these are the curve tools. This is quadratic curve and this is the bezier curve. Oh, it's not bizarre, right? So you can use this curve tool. Sorry. Yeah, not sorry. Actually, I can explain this button with you. So this is step forward and this is step backward. So if you want to undo anything, you can click this. And if you want to redo anything, you can click the step forward. So let's undo it for the time being. And let's use this curve just to show you what is its use. So it can make a curve. And this is the other curve tool. A bit similar to me though. Okay, then is a polygon tool. You can make polygon clicking this. Whatever polygon you want, you can make. I'm trying to make a triangle. Oh, it's spoiling it. Then this is circle and rectangle. So I'm just explaining these things to you. Further, this is the cursor. Now say you have selected the pencil tool, you are explaining something and then you want to come to the cursor. So you can click it, your cursor will be back as normal. Now it's very messy. If we want to clear it, we have two options. First, we can use the eraser. For example, I want that this arrow should be there, but these curve lines should not be there. So I can just remove these curves and this arrow shall remain. Or if I want that it has become very messy, I should clear it out. I can click on this erase all tool. So it will erase everything at one go. The page is clean now. So we have covered this polygon, then ellipse and rectangle, the cursor, eraser and then fill. Now paint bucket, fill an area. If you are not selecting any area, what would it do? Let me show you. I'll click it and then I pour the bucket here. The whole page is gone. So here comes to your rescue, the step backward button, undo. So if we have, you know, any figure, any enclosed area, and then we want to use paint bucket here. Let's change the color to see the effect, right? Now let's pour it here. So you see that it has covered only the enclosed area. If you will not select anything, then it will go everywhere on the screen. So these are the settings. If you want to create the shortcuts for these tools, you can create your own shortcuts A, B, C, or you can have Control plus Shift plus P for pencil. And then for picker also, you can say color picker. So you can have C for that. For text, you can have T. It's your wish, whatever shortcuts you want to create and then save it. So these hotkeys would be created and you can use shortcuts then. So this panel I've explained. Now I'm coming to the other very nice tool that WebPaint gives you, which is taking a screenshot. Now, for example, you are taking some topic. You are making your students show a video on your screen. You are sharing your screen and this video is going on. Let's pause it. Now you're explaining them. Okay, let's have this tool by here. Okay, then, you know, in animate objects, when they have, you know, they are spoken of as if they are alive, it is called personification. So you are explaining this, then you give some example. For example, let's talk a wall being having life or moon being. So you are explaining these things and then you should take a screenshot of this so that it can be useful to students. You can post it or you can share it in the other class, whatever reason. So you can simply click on this camera icon. This will take a screenshot. And not just screenshot, what you can do, you can download it. Let me show you. So this screenshot is downloaded. You can print it, you can just copy it to the clipboard and you can crop it also. If you want only this screen should be there, so you can crop it and then save it. Let's press the finish button. So this is how you can use all the features of WebPaint. So this is it. I have explained you all the tools of WebPaint. And yes, these last two buttons, this one is to close the control panel and this is to quit. If you press any of these, you have to again go to the WebPaint icon to have this toolbar here. So you can use it at your own convenience. You can have a lot of things with that. And the best part is you can take screenshot. If you are using a blank screen and annotating on it or explaining some mathematical concepts, you can always take the screenshots of that which can later help your students. So that is it. I hope it would be helpful to all of you. Do use this tool. It is a really good Chrome extension. And keep doing well. This is Priya Hanna signing off. May God bless you all.